Hi everyone. I know that it's a little bit late in school year, but I'm just going to show you how I take notes. And this is, I know it's a little bit late, this is my homework. But I just went to a soccer game and we tied. So I just literally just got started doing my homework at like 5 o'clock at night. But I'm glad it's only like the first week, so I only have a couple of weeks that I have to do. Okay. So I don't really like having it. So this is my World History binder. As you can tell, it's the same World History binder. No. No. It just says World History, and then this is my teacher's name. And then this is my period, which is period 6. But in it, I just have what we worked on in class that we're going to work on. And then the World History chronologically, which is what we're working on in class. There's 20 things that we have to learn. And then I have my pre-notes for my amazing, fun, actually done essay. Now, I know that's a lot hectic, but let me just explain a thing. So, my pre-notes. I like to go on the internet and take notes there, not wanting to worry about anything else. I just took notes there and everything. And then, for this, you always have to have topics to start. And I use a graphic organizer I got from 7th grade, which I copied. And it's really helpful for me. I do have socials last week. I always check this over. Well, I have right after lunch. So, in high school lunch, I don't really check you out or anything. So, I'm just going to, like, maybe do it during lunch. But I did it. Sorry. I'm sorry, guys. I'm soccer. I have it after lunch, actually. Every day. So I'll show you some other homework, but my other homework is just, that's my other homework, it's math, it's a personality checklist, I don't understand, but that, basically what this is you basically have a topic sentence, you have a couple of inner sentences, and then you have an ending one, and, we got told, like, an ending one could be, like, why you picked the date, so I said, I chose this date slash event to learn more about something I vaguely remember from last year. And then my beginning sentence was, King John was the king of England in 1215 when the barons of England decided that the king was overlooking the peoples, such their rights. Therefore, they wrote up the Magna Carta, the Great Charter, to remind and force the king to check with the barons opposing unfair taxes. The Magna Carta states that if 25 barons overrule the king, then the king must retract the item he imposed. That's just one basic thing, and it always has to, like, lead on. So, for instance, they wrote it up, and then states, and then it did, the Magna Carta was signed in Runnymede, England, as a promise to stop imposing taxes upon the people from the king. So the first document placed upon the king under law, not above law. This document is very important because it is the basis of some English rules and laws today. So it basically brings it to the present, which I like. But I really like this. I'll look something that you like. I don't have a textbook I can show you. But I do have a lot of homework I have to do still. So I'm going to actually end this video. Because have you seen how much homework I have to do? It's looking like this column. I don't want to do it all. But I've got to do it because I have to go to my brother's soccer game tomorrow. So let's see, I don't want to do that. Oh crap, let's do that. That's times 2. That's a times 2. That's a check, right? That's a check. Okay, so I just have to cover both 2 books. I have 2 textbooks I have to cover. I don't think I'm supposed to bring the biology book back or the algebra book. I think I'm bringing the algebra book because she wants to check it, but yay. But yeah, first day was pretty hard. Second day was actually easier. It's just a little bit tough balancing a bunch of schedules. And now the weekend, so I can relax. Take it on. Okay, guys, thank you for watching the video. I know it's probably going to seem like a little bit. But bye!